Microscopic.
Willard Wigan has to be one of the most incredible artists we have ever met. He specialises in sculptures that are so small they fit in the eye of a needle and can only be seen and made with a microscope. Now, last week, his collection was sold and then insured for a massive £11 million. We're very privileged to have his work in the studio this morning. And, of course, Willard himself. Welcome, Willard. Hi. This is fantastic.
I feel very honoured.
Oh, sure. So when you were a little boy, you were only five, I think, weren't you, when you first started making tiny things, what were the first things you did?
When I was a kid, I lived in a little fantasy world. I used to believe that ants had nowhere to live because I used to see them in the kitchen and my mum said that the only reason why they're in the kitchen is because they're homeless. So I started making houses for them. I wasn't satisfied with just making the house, and I decided to make furniture. And I made little tables and chairs. I made seesaws and swings.
Out of what?
Out of little splinters of wood. What I used to do is get a broken sliver of glass. Just if it would be detrimental for a kid at that age to actually do that themselves,
yeah.
I don't listen
yeah,
to
don't
me.
Don't do it. At home,
don't do it. Little microscopic speck of glass, and I'd hold a little splinter of wood, and I'd slice off little like beams, and I'd construct them and put them together with their own friction.
Have you got Superman's eyes? How did you manage to do that?
Well, what it is, I suppose it's a compensation because being at school at the time, I wasn't very good academically, so you find a way of compensating.
Well, this is one of those things you discover you can do and academia becomes irrelevant when you can do this. So this, here's the needle. Here you go. That's the ordinary needle there.
And
it's underneath the microscope at the moment.
Now, if you're very, very clever, you might be able to see a green, tiny little green speck inside the eye of the needle.
And there is what is in the eye of the needle. And that... So, how you have to slow down your metabolism, your
That's
body,
correct,
your breathing
correct.
And your heartbeat so that the pulse in your fingers doesn't get in the way of your work.
Yeah. To give you some idea, I mean, some of the tools I use are very, very microscopic. They're like, they've got like little blades on the end of them. Some of them I use little diamond tips. Just sharpened tungsten. On the end there, some of the paintbrushes, it flies hairs off a fly's back to actually use as a paintbrush.
You've got to pluck a fly.
Well, I wouldn't go out my way to kill a fly because you may have a family at home or something. So what I'd do, if I found a dead fly, I'd put him beneath the microscope, pluck a hair off and then just shove it on the end of that
that's
little...
That's your paintbrush.
That's my paintbrush. Or
is it true that you use spider's web for masks?
Yeah, I did a ship once and I had to rig it with money spider's web. Because there was nothing, or I'd find floating particles of dust. You know when the sunlight comes through the window and you see floating particles? I would get one of those and slice it in half maybe four times.
How do you cut a dust particle in half?
Have you done some atomic work? Could you split the atom? Because I'm sure you could do.
Well, I know one thing for certain. The smaller my work, the more colossal the impact.
Yes.
So when people see my work, they just die. Some people... just disbelieve it completely.
Can you slide a few more
yes,
in there
okay.
so that we can have a look?
Henry VIII
that's
next.
All right.
Here, I'll just get that.
Is that Henry VIII?
That's right. I'll just get that right for you. Just one second. I'll get
it the right way up.
The right way, and I'll just get it focused.
Oh, that.
And you'll see Henry VIII there, and his six wives. Let's just.
Which ones are they, from left to right?
The first one's Fern. The second one.
Can I have a look?
No, there's Catherine of Arrogant, and then there's Henry VIII, Anne Boleyn.
Yes.
But if you, if I just get that focus right
Can
there, you'll
look.
See.
Look at the faces.
Yeah. No, if I just, you'll see that there.
Good Lord.
You'll see Henry VIII looks like he's even got his dagger. He's got his traditional stance.
Yes. Like the whole Byron painting.
Yeah, the whole thing.
So that took you how long to do that?
You're talking 3 months, 3.5 months, because what actually happens when you start doing it, it becomes miserable and painstaking. It almost sends you mad, but I had to train my patience not to run out. It's like you're disciplining your mind, your body, your soul, because you have to slow all your nervous system down. So what I do, I kind of work like that, and I sort of wait for my pulse to go, and then... Because, as you know, your heart pumps blood around your body, and there's a pulse in your finger, so I have to wait, and I work between the heartbeats. So I have 1.5 seconds to move because if I don't, the pulse in my finger can be detrimental and it can destroy the work.
Could you put another one on? Wizard of Oz.
Well, I just say these have been bought by David Lloyd, the famous ex-tennis player and tennis coach, and these are at the David Lloyd Museum. Mm-hmm. Now, this is Wizard of Oz, and you have got Toto the dog there somewhere.
In there.
Can you spot him at home?
Toto. He's actually in there to get the focus.
He's the third one in from the left, a tiny little speck on the floor. Is that right?
Yeah, he's a little speck. There's Dorothy. She's got ruby red slippers on.
What's the wand? What's the blue fairy's wand made out of?
24 karat gold.
Is it?
So the wand is actually a floating fibre out of the air. I had to slice it three times because it was too big. In order to put the wand in
hand. You'd be very good as a forensic scientist as well, wouldn't you?
I had to drill a hole through the fairy's hand and then put the actual wand through. Because I can't actually use any form of glue. I have to sort of make little holes in the top of the needle and then just sort of shove them in.
I don't think this is you doing it. I think you have little fairies who come in at night and do it, don't you?
Well, you've earned your MBE, which you pick up, I think, is it the 12th of July?
Congratulations
on that. Thank you so much for coming. Just slide one more that we haven't seen underneath there. Just quickly there. What's that one?
This is a doll's house.
A doll's house. Oh, this is the one with the upstairs and the downstairs.
Yeah, you'll be able to see.
Look at that.
Just a minute, let's get the focus right. If I can just bring it in closer. You should see Wendy there. That's her name, Wendy, the little.
Wendy, where is she? There she is.
Oh,
she's got a little dressing table there.
What is she made
out of? I made that out of some fibre. Sometimes I use a human hair to carve with, but if she was that small, I couldn't use a human hair to use a fibre. And even though you're seeing it, there's a lot more detail because there's lights, you know.
Listen, Willard, thank you very much indeed. That's fantastic.